Today, reports circulated that the police had issued an ultimatum to those inside. Give up.
The explanation for the siege was that Parliament had handed out guns to defenders who had clear signs of mental disorder. No one was allowed to penetrate the security cordon, neither journalists nor deputies.
Rutskoy, 1 week ago.
Yeltsin makes decisions depending on the amount of alcohol consumed.
Chairman of the outlawed Parliament, Ruslan Khasbulatov, calls Yeltsin a fascist.
They want to turn this into something like a concentration camp. The criminal junta is coming closer to its goal.
Chairman of the Parliament, Ruslan Khasbulatov, held a news conference and charged that Boris Yeltsin headed a fascist regime.
They want to turn us into something like a closed concentration camp. There is barbed wire outside. You saw it. There have been more people blocking the White House. So every day of staying here in the walls of Parliament is, to put it mildly, an inconvenience, for the criminal junta is bringing closer to its end.
Said Mr. Yeltsin was turning Parliament into a concentration camp.
Yes, I think we shall be here as long as it is necessary to defeat the junta. I believe we can last here for a month or month and a half to bring order to the country. We are not intending to resort to weapons, and our security guards will not do it. But if they attack the White House and resort to weapons, if they resort to attack and terror, then, of course, those who have arms in their hands, those who are responsible for the protection of this building, who are responsible for the security of the legislature, will have to rebuff those who attack. Any drop of blood shed here is the responsibility of those who staged the coup d'etat. No matter what they say in mass media, no one will be able to escape responsibility for blood. Those who, those who staged this coup d'etat. We hope our countrymen will arise to help us and demand re-establishment of the rule of constitution and return of the country to the standards of normal civilized civilian society.
He has come to view himself as the vehicle of the entire historical process. On occasion, Yeltsin has said, "I report to no one. I report to God alone."
We are not engaged in any negotiations. I say once again that we will never be with any sort of negotiations. Absolutely no negotiations will satisfy us. While the regime exists.
Yeltsin dissolved Parliament last week, but he insists he won't take the building by force.
Here, inside, Ruslan Khasbulatov, the parliamentary speaker, had appeared looking tired and drawn.
Almost unrecognizable from tiredness and strain, entered the Parliament chamber and showed deputies that under his suit and tie, he was wearing a bulletproof vest.
Yeltsin's chief rival, Ruslan Khasbulatov, put on a bulletproof vest and vowed to fight to the end.
He displayed to his colleagues. Later, he claimed the White House could hold out for 6 weeks. He again called on the army to join him, derided what he called the fascists outside, and said the White House defenders would fight back.
News this morning, Russian President Boris Yeltsin tightening his grip on the Russian Parliament building in Moscow. At least 2,000 helmeted riot police now surround it. Yesterday, Yeltsin ruled out any compromise with the Parliament members still holed up inside, but has promised not to use any force to get them out. The chairman of the renegade parliament remains defiant.
Holdouts in the blacked-out parliament chamber were threatened with the stick.
100 or so deputies continued to hold a make-believe session of Congress by candlelight. Futile though their votes may be, this hard core of deputies is determined not to surrender. The question remains, will they have to be flushed out by force?
But inside Parliament, the deputy said it was Boris Yeltsin who was crazy and a criminal.
Still, this morning things seem somewhat less tense than yesterday, and certainly less tense than last night, when there was a major show of force. Inside the Russian Parliament, the defiant deputies still meet, and they still refuse to obey Mr. Yeltsin's order that they disband.
with their electricity shut off, they meet by candlelight, and they communicate with megaphones. Many of the deputies have abandoned their vigil. Perhaps only 150 of the original 600 remain in the parliament building. Throughout the night, there were sporadic clashes on the streets of Moscow as supporters of the
angry residents cut off by the expanded security cordon from their homes joined with pro-communist supporters trying to break into the compound. This time, the injuries were minor.
Tuesday, some 1,500 anti-Yeltsin supporters tried to get into the parliament building, but thousands of troops...
But was heard on police bullhorns...
...determined to converge on the White House to support the embattled deputies there.
We charged adrenaline. The demonstrators tried to break through police lines to reach the parliament building. Challenged the picket line set up yesterday.
And Yeltsin is sending in more troops to bolster the forces that already surround the parliament building. Ministry officials tried to communicate with lawmakers via bullhorn, urging them to leave, but they failed to respond to the warning. Boris Yeltsin has pledged not to use force to end a standoff.
Riot police with shields and batons.
Yeltsin's troops and supporters at the
crowd of demonstrators attempting to force its way into the grounds of the parliament.
As they move to extremes.
Mr. Yeltsin's massive display of force led perhaps inevitably to...
That provoked the authorities. Once the riot police got reinforcements, they beat back the protesters. But having expanded their security perimeter, the troops allowed those enraged by the reinforced siege of the parliament building to vent.
There were more than scuffles.
Overnight, anti-Yeltsin protesters turned one Moscow street into a minor urban battlefield. Communist and Russian nationalists...
Tempers flared as riot police tried to keep back about 1,000 anti-Yeltsin demonstrators.
Gods, shame on you, she screams.
Shame, shame, they yell.
Shame, the crowd.
The deadline for surrender, an attempt to force a crisis.
Tonight, the standoff turned ugly.
The wait 'em out approach has given way to eyeball-to-eyeball confrontation.
Demonstrators squeezed out of their habitat at the back of the Russian White House clashed briefly with riot police.
Hundreds of protesters marched down a major street in Moscow tonight.
Thousands of anti-Yeltsin demonstrators kept away from the White House.
Demonstrators seized control of a few key spots in central Moscow, including one just down the street from the U.S. Embassy building.
Emphasizes while others built makeshift barriers. The White House is in the heart of Moscow. What started as a political confrontation has spread.
Tried to block a major street tonight.
And then tried to block it off. But the barricades they built were quickly removed by police. Yes,
the infuriated anti-Yeltsin protesters responded to the police blockade of parliament by building their own barricades across Moscow's inner ring.
Largest deployment of security forces since Yeltsin took office 2 years ago.
Security zone around the White House.
Up the crisis right to the barricades. They dragged a trolley across an intersection, blocking for a few minutes one of the city's main boulevards.
Night that tension spilled out into the streets.
The demonstrators commandeered three trolley buses and blocked the major traffic artery before...
Commandeered trolley buses and stacked up junk, causing traffic chaos.
They built barricades with whatever materials they could rip and drag into the open.
Yeltsin has said he will not use force to end the standoff, but to...
The police. And that Yeltsin denies issuing. An ultimatum that Yeltsin denies issuing.
The tension. Riot police confronted jeering new barricades outside the area were quickly suppressed, but added a new dimension.
Riot police moved in to clear the flimsier barricades. But the
atmosphere... Side streets with police on their heels.
Police received minor injuries. CNN's Eileen O'Connor sums up those events.
Earlier, a group of demonstrators attempted to...
Police have been busy in the streets.
Now, the latest victim of the political turmoil.
Is mounting in Moscow, where Russian President Boris Yeltsin is trying to flush his...
Overnight, scuffles on the barricade.
Protesters today clashed with riot police on a major city avenue.
The attempt...
Rivals out of the city's parliament building. Anti-Yeltsin being blocked from demonstrating outside the Russian parliament, which is cordoned off behind barbed wire.
Tensions run high in Moscow as the standoff between hardliners and government troops
being pushed under a moving car during this demonstration Tuesday night.
Some pro-communist demonstrators rampaged through the streets near Parliament, throwing rocks and damaging some cars. They were quickly broken up by riot troops.